Welcome to this yoga class recorded in the middle of the Amazon forest, close to Manaus in Brazil. Expect a yin yoga sequence you can practice off the mat, so no need for props nor a yoga mat. Feel free though to use a pillow or blanket to put under sensitive ankles or knees. Start in a comfortable seated position. Pay attention to the natural breath. Let's go to the first pose, a squat, to open the hips. Move spontaneously to find a position you can hold for a while. It can look differently to my posture since bodies are different. On an inhale, open the heart. On an exhale, bow the head, rounding the spine. Decide which expression of the squat you want to stay in. Know that you can move the torso and the feet during the hold, as long as you move with intention. When you feel strain or can't relax the body or mind anymore, release the pose slowly and perhaps return to a different expression. Rest in any relaxation pose of your choice whenever necessary. Possible areas you'll feel a stretch are inner thighs, back of the thighs, perhaps calves, back and neck. You can focus on the physical sensations you feel or bring the attention back to the natural breath. Slowly release the squat and go to a kneeling position with the spine upright. If kneeling puts strain on feet, ankles or knees, choose any other seated posture. Notice the effect of the previous pose. Possible physical sensations you might feel are tingling, pins and needles, difference in temperature, and so on. Open the knees comfortably apart and fold the upper body. Walk the hands forward and over to one side until you generate a mild stretch over the side of the torso and neck, perhaps along the arm. Hold and release with each exhalation. Walk the hands over to the other side and repeat the side stretch. Walk the hands back to the center. Lift the head and torso upright. From a kneeling position, tuck the toes under to stretch the toes and over the soles of the feet. Try to relax the feet and continue to breathe smoothly. To make this toe stretch less intense, lean forward on the hands. Now move into a lunge position called Dragon Pose in Yin Yoga. Choose any variation or move with me from high to low dragon. In the upright version, the stretch along the thighs will probably be more pronounced in the front of the back thigh and hip. It is okay to open the front foot more to the side and to wing the knee open for winged dragon. Stay here or move with me to low dragon, folding the head and upper body and maybe leaning on the forearms. Feel free to add a twist, turning the chest to the front leg. Depending on the shape of the posture and your unique body, sensations might differ. In this low version, possibly sensations over the thigh of the front leg will be more pronounced. As long as no pain is felt and sensations of stretch or pressure are mild, the position you are holding is perfect for you. release dragon pose, and go to any resting pose in which you can feel the effect on body and mind of the previous pose. This is called rebound in yin. Now move to dragon pose on the second side. Explore this low lunge position by taking a longer or shorter stance, opening the knee more to the side, perhaps swinging the knee open as well, rolling onto the outer edge of the foot, staying more upright as me, or folding forward if you prefer. Turn the chest to the front leg for a twisted version. Hold any variation you're in or move into a different expression. I am moving into a twisted dragon, and after a while I'll move into low dragon, sometimes called gecko, comparable to lizard pose and other hatha yoga styles. Finally, we can release this challenging posture and move into a resting pose of your choice. Any neutral pose that allows you to dive within and feel the rebound. From your relaxation pose, move spontaneously towards a seated position with the legs extended forward and comfortably apart. Relax the leg muscles. Come to a forward fold called caterpillar in yin. The function of this pose is to generate a stretch somewhere along the back line of the body. It can feel more concentrated along the back of the legs or the lower back. Perhaps both combined. A slight pressure into the abdomen is possible and beneficial for abdominal organs. release the forward fold and move into any rebound position of your choice that fits into the space you're practicing in. Let's move towards the backbend as a counterpose for the previous forward fold. Function of the backbend is to generate a therapeutic pressure over the lower back combined with the stretch over the front line of the body that some might feel as a stretch over the belly. Open the legs comfortably apart and let the feet turn in or out. Choose how high you want to lift the torso. Elbows or hands are placed in a way to support the upper body in a desired height. It is okay to sink down in between the shoulders. Find your unique alignment for fingers, hands, and elbows so that no strain is felt. Choose a mild pressure in lower back. We are halfway through the time you hold this pose. Feel free to stay exactly where you are, lower the torso, or lift the torso higher. I am moving from Sphinx, leaning on the elbows, to a more intense backbend called Seal in Yin, leaning on the hands. Keep the head in desired position, somewhere in between chin to chest, and tilting the head back. release the back bend and rest in a neutral posture. Let the sensations fade. Temporary achiness can be felt. Let's move to the last posture of the sequence, an easy recline twist on both sides. Start lying on the back, bend the knees and squeeze the thighs towards the chest. Lower the knees down to one side, opening opposite arm to the floor as a counterweight. It is okay if the shoulder or the knees are lifted off the floor. Try out if it feels okay for the neck to turn the head away from the knees. Allow gravity to pull on knees and opposite shoulder. Turn the attention to the natural breath to stay present with the mind. Slowly release the spinal twist and move the knees and the head back to the middle. Stay. Let's repeat the spinal twist to the other side. Look for an expression of the twist that fits you. Maybe you'll prefer the knees higher or lower down. Finally, surrender to stillness. come out of the spinal twist and go to relaxation pose. Stay open for the effect of the effort you made. Wake up the body and come to seated. Notice how you feel as a whole. Thank you for practicing with me. Namaste.